नमस्ते चिल्ड्रन, वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट जंगल सफारी। टिल 31 पेज वी हैड डन, ओके। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न जंगल सफारी, अबाउट द जंगल सफारी। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय जंगल सफारी? ओके, बिफोर दैट वी लर्न, इट इज अंडर सी बिट, अंडर सी बिट 3.1। here are some questions are there for you. Have you ever visited any national park or wildlife sanctuary? Any time have you visited? Yes, you might have visited, or some who did not visited also, you try to go and visit. Wildlife sanctuary, what do you mean by wildlife sanctuary? An area where animal habitat and their surroundings are protected from any sort of disturbance. Okay, like in that area, capturing, killing, poaching are like that, these are all prohibited. No one will allow to enter that area, that full area, that 100 acres are surrounded with are covered, are surrounded by a fencing. No one will allow to get into that place. If they anybody enter the place, they will be under, they will go under prison. Okay, names of some national parks and animal sanctuaries are given below. Some national parks are given here, wildlife sanctuaries also. Write the names of the states, don't write the place name, just states where they are situated. The Cobbett National Park is a Jim Cobbett National Park. Where it is? It is in Uttarakhand. Now Bandhavgarh National Park, where it is in Madhya Pradesh. Okay, Bandhavgarh National Park, where it is in Madhya Pradesh. Gir Wildlife Sanctuary, it is in Gujarat. Okay, now one more name is mentioned here, Kanha National Park. It is also in the Madhya Pradesh. Where it is in the Madhya Pradesh. So we have to know, if you want to know about this national parks, you can visit the net and you can Google it, you may get more, but under your parents supervision you have to do all this. My experiment was its peak, sorry, my excitement was at its peak. Excitement means nothing but very happiness. Okay, suppose you have seen your friend, UKG friend or any KG friend or any old friend. Okay, with your excitement, you wave your hand at them. Okay, very happiness. Was peak. Peak means extreme level, very high level. Means they are very, very, very happy. We are, my excitement means, who is this why? My is nothing but author who had written this lesson. My excitement was at its peak. We were going to visit Kanha National Park, which is provided setting for Rudyard Kipling's classic novel, The Jungle Book. Have you seen, children, have you seen The Jungle Book? I hope you all seen that. Who did not, please watch the film. The Jungle Book is very, very good film. Okay. Who had written this? Rudyard Kipling. Directed by Rudyard Kipling. And a classic novel. Classic novel is nothing but the best one. Best classic novel, Jungle Book. Okay. And that, what did you learn here? The Jungle Book film is taken in this Kanha National Park. The setting is provided by this national park. Okay. Everything, the forest area and all, everything set by this Kanha National Park. We slept early that night so that we could get up early the next morning. Anytime, everybody experienced this one. How, suppose you have some one day that trip, any, what we say that, like excursion or any trip is there in your school, that before night you will sleep early. and you will get up early to bed and early to rise. Why will you sleep early? Because to get up early. Why you have to get up early? To get ready for the tour or for the trip. So in the same way, the author not only one person, more are there. They mentioned here we. So we slept early that night so that we could get up early the next morning. So we could get up means they can get up. To get up early, they slept early, simple. As the alarm rang, alarm means what? Alarm means we will set time to ring. Okay, as the alarm rang, my sister and who are we here? The author and author's sister. Who wrote this lesson? That person and sister. I jumped out of our beds and quickly started to get ready for one of our thrilling journey ever. See, ever means not happened till now. So they are eagerly waiting for that journey, for the trip. So when alarm rang, immediately they got up from the bed, jumped out. Means what? They climbed down from the bed and they quickly started to get ready for they went washroom and they brushed their teeth. After that, they took bath and all they had done. Why? To go. Their happiness are in high peak, extreme level. And thrilling means what? What do you mean by thrill? It's a great kind of excitement. Okay. Journey ever. This kind of, traveling in train, traveling in bus, it's a common journey. But traveling in the forest, it's a kind of different thing, not normal thing. That's why they are very happy to go to that journey. A visit to Kanha National Park on a boat. What kind of a journey is that? A visit to Kanha National Park. How? On a boat. This was the first time we were going to experience it and very thought-infused zeal in me. See, they are going to visit Kanha National Park on a boat for first excitement, and they are traveling in the forest, not on the roads, not in the air, not in the water, in the boat, that too in the forest. That is a sanctuary, a national park. This was the first time we were going to experience. The author doesn't have this kind of experience earlier. The author did not go this kind of traveling earlier ago. So now they are going to experience. They are going to this kind of traveling, and it is very thought and. Very thought infused zeal in me. Infused means here fill. See, fill means what? See, suppose cake, or suppose we will take cake. Cake is infused with flavor, a nice flavor. Means what? Filled with a nice flavor. Okay, to eat. By that flavor, you feel that I want to eat that. That foodie flavor, they infuse the cake. Like zeal. Zeal is nothing but passion, enthusiasm. So to know about zeal is nothing but eagerness also, we say that. Because this is that jungle safari is the new kind of experience for the author and author's sister. And they are traveling in the forest. They did not have this kind of experience earlier. So they want to go as early as possible to reach the, to get into the boat, to travel in the forest. And very thought infused zeal means it's a kind of the zeal, enthusiasm is filled in me. What is the author means? Infused zeal is nothing but a kind of excitement, a great excitement is there in the author ideas, author thoughts. He author thoughts are running very fast than him. He's saying that one. Okay. Now I will read this lesson, the first para. Next class only I will explain this one. As we approached the lake, the foggy weather did not deter our spirits. As we approached the lake, they went near the lake. The foggy weather, the weather is very fog. I think you have seen that second video. The weather is very fog. You can't see that when fog is there during. Winter season, you can see the fog in the mornings. So fog, it's a kind of snow falling on that in the atmosphere, in the weather. We did not that foggy weather, that blur kind of, not clear weather, blur weather did not deter our spirit, did not stop. Deter is nothing but stop. Our spirits means which is want to go and visit the Kanha National Park, to go into the forest. So this foggy weather is there, even though they did not stop their visit. Deter, stop. Our spirits means a state of mind, their idea, their feeling. Okay, there was an exclusive boat waiting for our family. So that earlier, the previous page only, the author said that we are traveling on the boat in the Zim Kanha National Park. So the for their family, a boat was waiting. We quickly hopped into the boat. Hopped means what? Jumped into that boat. While the mist unfolded over the waters of the vast artificial lake, I was mesmerized by the beauty of the nature around me. It's very, very good, beta. So it's not so simple to explain. See here, there was a, we quickly, very fast, hopped into the boat. They jumped into the boat with that excitement. When we will visit, when we will go inside, happiness, with a lot of happiness, they jumped into the boat. While the mist unfolded over the waters, mist is nothing but it's a kind of watery kind of thing, and the water, mist is nothing but fog like only, but fog is slowly turning into water, that is called mist. Unfolded means what? Folded means covered, unfolded means removing. See here, packing, unpacking. You are packing your bag, unpacking bag means you are taking books from bag. You are packing means keeping the books in your bag. Packing, unpacking, like that. Folding, unfolding is nothing but folded. Unfolded means what? So clearing over waters of the vast artificial lake. I was mesmerized by the beauty of the nature around me. Till here I will stop. So what happened? I was mesmerized. Why? Mesmerized means what? It's a kind of feeling. It means what? Capture the complete attention. Mesmerized means what? You cannot turn your eyes from something. Mesmerized means totally engrossed in some particular thing. Okay. That is mesmerized and vast. Vast means very large, extremely big. Artificial lake is not a lake formed by the nature. Artificial. The people, the government made the lake to stop the water. Okay. Next. Here, the author experienced this kind of feeling here. The first, the author started, he said about the Kanha National Park visit, and till here I was mesmerized by the beauty of the nature around me. With that beautiness of nature, he was stuck there. He was not turning his head. He doesn't want to move from that place because he likes that place a lot. So this is the first lesson, first part I completed from this lesson. Next to next lesson, next tomorrow or next lesson, I will go from here. Explanation part, I will complete this lesson next. Okay. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.